For legendary film director and actress Kira Muratova, Odessa was home. Amazingly, she only retired from filmmaking in her late 70s after a hugely successful career. She called the Odessa Film Studio, and particularly the cutting room, her heaven on earth. Kira Muratova's trademark style made her an industry icon. Her films won significant awards, like the 1990 Grand Prix of the Berlin Film Festival. But perhaps more importantly, they won the hearts of the viewers and influenced countless other artists, like the young Ukrainian director Maxim Nakonechny.
She inspired me to seek a language of my own method and style.
Kira Muratova worked with many acclaimed artists. It is widely believed that she was the one who encouraged the legendary Soviet songwriter and actor Vladimir Vysotsky to develop his signature raspy voice.
All the actors she worked with were completely in love with her. On her set, there was this atmosphere of improvisation, and she watched the actors do their thing and allowed them to improvise. She then put that into her movies.
At the same time, Muratova always liked to cast local Odessa actors. The founder of the now legendary comic company, Maskisho Georgi Daliyev, was among her favorites.
Sometimes she could get irritated when things didn't go well, but by and large, when we communicated outside work, she was a very warm person.
Kira Muratova saw cinema as the realm of freedom. She liked to say that films gave her the room to breathe fully and to do whatever she wanted. Muratova always managed to express herself freely despite the Soviet censorship.
In art, such personalities don't appear all that often. This is a truly great loss for Ukraine, but naturally, people don't live forever, and the best thing we can do is to revive Ukrainian cinema and to ensure that Ukraine's talents have the conditions to create and to realize themselves without facing the kind of obstacles that Kira Muratova encountered on her creative path.
Despite keeping a low profile in recent years, Kira Muratova was an outspoken supporter of the Euromaidan anti-government protests and of Ukraine in the face of Russian aggression.
Multiple times, even after she became a recluse, she continued to stress that she was a patriot of Ukraine and is categorically against the annexation of Crimea, against the war and Russia's conquest.
Although in her work she never dealt with the big politics directly, instead focusing on universal themes, Muratova concentrates on the landscapes and characters that are unique products of the Soviet and post-Soviet life in all of its absurdity. Having directed 44 films, Kira Muratova's contribution in Ukrainian and world cinema cannot be overestimated.